Hi students, all of you, good morning. Welcome to the class. Please open the polymers chapter in your volume 4 material and open the objective exercise 2. The first question is, which of the following is fully fluorinated polymer? Fully fluorinated polymer. And one of the option given is, what is the options given? Second option is Teflon. Fully fluorinated polymer. Yes, the answer is Teflon. How can we say Teflon? Because Teflon is represented as CF2, single bond CF2, single bond taken n times. This is the Teflon. Taken n times means poly. And it is coming from tetrafluoroethene. And the reaction is tetrafluoroethene. This is the tetrafluoroethene. Tetrafluoroethene. Yes, this is the one tetrafluoroethene. How many times it is taken means n times. N molecules is taken. When it is undergoing polymerization, this pi bond is going to be broken. Then we can write CF2, single bond CF2. When a pi bond is broken, two sigma bonds are formed. Two new sigma bonds are formed. This is the one new sigma bond. This is the another new sigma bond. And these units are repeated n times. So this one is known as polytetrafluoroethene. Simply it is called as Teflon. So Teflon is containing fluorine atoms. So we can say that the fully fluorinated polymer is Teflon. Otherwise it is also known as polytetrafluoroethene. So that is the answer. Option number 2. When you are watching my video lectures, wherever you want to make a pass, P-A-U-S-E, pass, you can press on the pass button, you can write down the notes. If any doubt is there, text me in the chat box. Right, next question number 5. Question number 5. Which of the following is elastomer? Question number 5. Which of the following is elastomer? Yes, elastomers means having elastic nature. Elastic nature. What are having elastic nature? Rubbers are having elastic nature. Rubbers are classified into two types. One is natural rubbers and the second one is synthetic rubbers. So two types of rubbers are there, natural rubbers and synthetic rubbers. If you see the textbook, examples given for the synthetic rubbers are, what are the examples given? Neoprene, Buna N, Buna S. These are the examples of synthetic rubbers. Whereas natural rubber is, what is natural rubber means? Poly isoprene is the natural rubber. So all these are the examples of elastomers because they are having elastic nature. Right, if you see the options, fifth question, objective exercise 2, page number 141, question number 5, which of the following is elastomer? First option, Buna N. Second option, Buna S. Third option, neoprene. So all these are the examples of elastomers. So for the question number 5, the answer is fourth option. So all these are the theory bits. If you can understand the theory by watching the recorded video lectures, by yourself you can easily solve the MCQs. No need of any explanation. Right. Next, question number 7. Objective exercise 2, page number 141. Question number 7. Yes, what is the question? Which of the following is an example of copolymer? Which of the following is an example of copolymer? Copolymer means it contains two different types of copolymers contain two different types of monomers. So if you see the options, fourth option, if you observe the fourth option, option 4, what is given for option 4? PET. Generally PET means a physical education training, but it is not that one. Here PET means a polyethylene terephthalate. If you see this word 8, 8 is indicating it is an ester. So PET, it is an example of ester first of all, and it is containing two different types of monomers. The first monomer is ethylene glycol, that is represented as CH2, single bond OH, single bond CH2, single bond OH. This is the first monomer, ethylene glycol. And the second monomer is terphthalic acid. The terphthalic acid is represented as a benzene ring. The para positions are substituted on the benzene ring. The opposite positions, that is the para positions, are substituted with carboxylic acid groups. That is the terphthalic acid. So simply we can say that PET, that is polyethylene terephthalate, is containing two different types of monomers. Hence, PET is an example of copolymer. Yes, my dear students, can you say whether PET is a condensation polymer or not? Whether PET is an example of condensation polymer or not? Can anybody say? Chirant, respond. If PET is an example of condensation polymer or not? How can we say it is a condensation polymer? How can we say it is a condensation polymer? To become a condensation polymer, here I am saying about PET. PET is an example of copolymer as well as condensation polymer. To become a condensation polymer, the polymer must contain, sorry, the monomer must contain, the monomers must contain two different types of monomers must contain two different types of functional groups. The monomers must contain two different types of functional groups. If you say the first monomer, ethylene glycol, it is containing which functional group? ethylene glycol is containing alcohol functional group, single bond OH, that is called as alcohol. And the second monomer, terthalic acid. This is the one terthalic acid. The terthalic acid is containing which functional groups? Terthalic acid is containing carboxylic acid functional groups. Here, alcohol functional group. So whenever monomers are containing two different types of functional groups, then such polymer is going to be formed by condensation polymerization. Then we can say that PET, that is polyethylene terephthalate, is an example of condensation polymer. Having two different types of monomers, hence PET is an example of copolymer. So finally, we can conclude that PET, that is polyethylene terephthalate, is an example of copolymer as well as condensation polymer. Very important bit. Please remember this one. PET. It is an example of copolymer and condensation polymer. It contains which type of functional groups? Two types of functional groups. That is, first monomer containing alcohol functional group. Second monomer containing carboxylic acid functional group. So that is about question number 7. Next, question number 8. Read the question number 8. Once again, volume 4, objective exercise 2, page number 141. Question number 8. Which of the following statements about terlene are correct? Which of the following statements about terlene are correct? Question number 8. So here the polymer is, terlene is a polymer. Can you say whether it is a polyester or polyamide? First of all, terlene is an example of condensation polymer. Condensation polymer. And terlene is an example of copolymer. So about terlene, we can say that it is a copolymer and it is a condensation polymer. Condensation polymer. The terlene is containing two different types of monomer units. The first monomer unit is ethylene glycol. That is CH2 single bond OH single bond, CH2 single bond OH. The second one is terephthalic acid. Terephthalic acid. Terlene is also called as Decron. Terephthalic acid. Just now I written the terephthalic acid. That is benzene ring having COOH groups at the opposite positions of the benzene ring. This is the terephthalic acid. Yes, what is the question? Which of the following statements about terlene are correct? So first of all, it is containing two different types of monomer units. Hence, it is a copolymer. And whether it is an ester or not? Yes, it is an ester. Terlene, it is an example of ester. How can we say it is ester? Yes, esters are formed by the reaction of alcohols with carboxylic acids. Esters are formed by the reaction of alcohols with carboxylic acid. See here, alcohol functional group is there. Here, carboxylic acid functional group is there. So whenever an alcohol reacting with carboxylic acid, the reaction is said to be esterification reaction. That means formation of esters is called as esterification reaction. So already I said that ethylene glycol is containing OH functional group. So for my convenient, I am writing first carboxylic acid. For my convenient, I am writing first carboxylic acid. That is the terphthalic acid. And second one is the alcohol. That is ethylene glycol. Carboxylic acid, the functional group is written as single bond COOH. Alcohol, the functional group is written as single bond O, single bond H. Just observe carefully. The alcohol functional group is written as single bond O, single bond H. Carboxylic acid functional group is written as single bond C, double bond O, single bond O, single bond H. Whenever carboxylic acid is reacting with alcohol, here removal of water molecule is going to take place. Removal of a small molecule is going to take place. Whenever a polymer is going to be formed by the removal of small molecules, that polymerization is called as condensation polymerization. Once again, whenever a polymer is going to be formed from the monomers by the removal of small molecules like water molecule, that process is called as condensation polymerization. Finally, in this reaction, water molecule is going to be removed. Then what is going to be formed? Single bond C, double bond O, single bond O, single bond. Yes. Now you can say that is the ester. What is the functional group of ester? Single bond C, double bond O, single bond O, single bond is called as ester. So simply you can say that what is meant by esterification? Formation of esters is called as esterification. When the carboxylic acids are going to react with alcohols, it is the formation of esters. And now we can say that terlene or decron, it is an example of terlene or decron is an example of polyester. Terlene or decron is an example of copolymer. Terlene or decron, that is an example of condensation polymer. Yes, check the options once. Question number 8, page number 141, question number 8. First option, some statements are given. Statement A, it is a polyester. Statement B, it is obtained by the reaction between ethylene glycol and terephthalic acid. Third statement, it is a condensation polymer. Fourth statement, it is a natural polymer. It is a natural polymer. It is not a natural polymer. It is a synthetic polymer. Man-made polymers, once again, man-made polymers are called as synthetic polymers. This is not a naturally occurring polymer. Yes, you will get a doubt. Sir, tell me one example for natural polymers. You will get a doubt. Sir, tell me one example for natural polymer. Yes, I can say that rubbers. All of you know the rubber trees. The rubber trees, they are going to excrete latex, the white color liquid. So from that latex, if we solidify that latex, we will get some substance, solid substance. That is called as rubber. That is an example of natural polymer. All of we are eating carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are classified into different types. Monosaccharides, oligosaccharides, and polysaccharides. Polysaccharides. Yes, all of you know the examples of polysaccharides. All the polysaccharides are the examples of naturally occurring polymers. Suppose if you take a starch, starch is a natural polymer, right? So whatever polymers which are obtained in the nature, they are called as natural polymers. Which are man-made, they are called as synthetic polymers. So terlene or decron is an example of synthetic polymer. It is known as a polyester. It is an example of copolymer. It is an example of condensation polymer. So the option is statement A, statement B, statement C are correct. That means option 3 is correct. So for the question number 8, the answer is option 3. very 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 important concept it is. Right, next question number 12. Once again I am saying, volume 4 chapter polymers, page number 141. Page number is 141. My dear students, if you are not getting understood, if you are not getting understood this class, please text me in the chat box. I will wait for 1 minute. Those who are not understanding this class, please text me in the chat box. I have to know how many students are not able to understand. If you are able to understand, text me in the chat box. Yes, the class is getting understood. By your response, I will continue the class. If you are understanding the class, text me in the chat box. All the students who are on the online, you have to text in the chat box. Your response must be given in the chat box. Because we want to know how many students are able to follow my class. All the students must text in the chat box, because the chart is going to be saved every day. Every day my chat box is saved. All the students must respond. Yes, thank you. Remaining students, please text in the chat box. And we will go for next question. Question number 12. Page number 141. Page number 141. Question number 12. Yes, what is the volume? Volume 4. Question number 12. Read the text. Read the question. Which one of the following polymer can be softened and hardened repeatedly on heating and cooling without change in its property? Which of the following polymer can be softened and hardened repeatedly on heating and cooling without change in its property? Yes, all of you know the plastic covers, plastic bags, polythene covers. All of you know about polythene covers. So whenever we take a polythene cover onto a stick, if the polythene cover is put into a flame, if the polythene cover is put into a flame, the polythene cover get melt. Then the obtained melt, if it is cooled, then again it becomes hard. So polythene is an example of which type of polymer? So based on the molecular forces, based on the molecular forces, based on molecular forces between the monomers, based on the molecular forces between the monomers, the polymers are classified, the polymers are classified into 4 types based on the molecular forces. Yes, in the first way, you see, in the chemical bonding, you studied about different types of attractive forces. Van der Waal force of attractions, dipole-dipole attractions, dipole-induced dipole attractions, and hydrogen bondings. Once again, between the molecules, different types of attractive forces are there. The first force is Van der Waal force of attraction. The second force is dipole-dipole attraction. The third force is dipole-induced dipole attraction. And the fourth one is hydrogen bonding. So like that, between the monomers, there are different types of molecular forces are there. So based on the molecular forces between the monomers, the polymers are classified into four types. What are the four types of polymers? Please see the textbook. There you can find the classification. The first one is elastomers. The second one is thermoplastics. The third one is thermosetting polymers. Thermosetting polymers, elastomers, and one more is fibers. Fibers. In your NCERT textbook, you can find this content. Classification of polymers based on molecular forces. Yes, I'm going to open the textbook. Yesterday I sent the PDF regarding this topic. Yesterday I sent the PDF. Once you open the PDF, there I underlined each and every point. Just by reading that content, you can understand the topic very easily. And this topic is very, very, very important topic. Most important topic from this polymers chapter, classification of polymers based on molecular forces. Yes, I'm going to share the screen. Yes, yesterday I sent the PDF. The same thing I'm going to share to you. On the screen, yes, on the screen you can see the PDF. Classification based on molecular forces. Just see the underlined words. Just observe the underlined words. Just observe the underlined words. So first classification is elastomers. Just a minute, I am taking the attendance. Please stay online. Still some students are not attending, some students are leaving the class. You are the loser finally on one day. Yes, classification of polymers based on molecular forces. The first one is elastomers. Elastomers are rubber like solids with elastic properties. With elastic properties. So here you can see elastomeric polymers are having weak intermolecular force of attractions, right? And the examples for elastomers are Buna-S, Buna-N, neoprene. All these are the examples of elastomers. Yes, once again, elastomers are having weak intermolecular forces like van der Waal force of attractions. Yes, one of the example for elastomer is neoprene. On the left side you can see neoprene. Neoprene is an example of elastomer. It is having very weak force of attractions between the monomer units. Right, that is about the first monomer, elastomer. Next, the second monomer, sorry, second polymer is fibers. Fibers are nothing but thread-like or thread-forming. Fiber is nothing but thread-like, thread-forming solids. So these fibers are having high tensile strength and high modules. And between the monomer units, strong intermolecular force of attractions are present. The strong intermolecular force of attractions are, what are the strong intermolecular force of attractions? Hydrogen bondings. So fibers are very strong in nature because between the monomer units, they are having strong intermolecular forces like hydrogen bondings. Because of this reason, the fibers are crystalline in nature. Crystalline means they are solids. Solids, crystalline in nature. And the examples are polyamides. Examples for polyamides is nylon 6,6, and the second one is polyesters or polyesters. Example for polyester is terlene or decron. So simply we can say that the examples for fibers are, what are the examples for fibers? On the left side you can see the examples for fibers are, the examples for fibers are polyesters and polyamides. So by understanding the polyamides and polyesters, we can understand the nature of fibers, right? And already we know that esters are formed by removal of water molecule by the reaction of alcohol and carboxylic acids. And polyamides are also formed by the removal of small molecules like water molecule. So simply you can say that polyesters, polyamides, they are the examples of fibers as well as condensation polymers. You have to remember all these things. So once again, the example, fibers are the examples of polyesters are the examples of fibers, and polyamides are the examples of fibers. Both polyesters and polyamides are the examples of condensation polymers, right? Okay, condensation polymers are having which type of intermolecular forces? Very strong intermolecular forces like hydrogen bondings. Next, coming to third one, thermoplastics. Just now I said that polythene, plastic covers, polythene covers. So polythene, that is a thermoplastic polymer. Just now I said that the thermoplastic polymer on heating get softened, on cooling get hardened. Once again, the thermoplastic polymers on heating get softened, on cooling get hardened. So this process can be repeated n number of times. That means any number of times we can soft and we can hard the thermoplastic polymers. The simple example for thermoplastic polymer is polythene covers, that is polythene. And one more example here is PVC, polyvinyl chlorides. Polyvinyl chlorides, they are the examples of thermoplastic polymers. Plastic, PVC, all of you know the PVC pipes, plastic pipes. So the plastic pipes, they are the examples of thermoplastic polymers. Polythene covers are the examples of thermoplastic polymers, right? Here you can see the examples, polythene, polystyrene, polyvinyls, all these are the examples of thermoplastic polymers. And they can be softened on heating, hardened on cooling. Yes, the last one, thermosetting polymer. Thermosetting means becoming hard. In the first PUC also, you studied about gypsum. In the first PUC, in the carbon family, you studied about gypsum. Gypsum on wetting up, by adding water to the gypsum becomes hard and hard and hard. Generally, if I take any chalk piece, suppose if a chalk piece is taken, if it is getting wetted up, it becomes soft. But when the gypsum is added with water, the gypsum becomes hard and hard and hard. Getting hard is called as setting process. So here, the fourth category is thermosetting polymers. So here, these polymers, upon heating, they become hard and hard and hard and hard by removal of water molecules, by the loss of water molecules. Between one monomer unit to another monomer unit, whenever water molecules are going to be removed, they are going to get joined with each other. Then they become hard and hard and hard. So thermosetting polymers, examples for thermosetting polymers are Bakelite and urea formaldehyde polymers. Bakelite and urea formaldehyde polymers, they are the examples of thermosetting polymers. My dear students, exclude this thermosetting polymers. Just exclude the thermosetting polymers. Just see the three polymers. The first polymer is elastomers, Second polymer is fibers. Third polymer is thermoplastic polymers. Yes, based on the molecular forces, which polymer is very strong, which polymer is weak, which one is intermediate. You have to text your answer to my WhatsApp number because the time is very less. Yes, text me in the chat box whether the class is understood or not. The time is very less. Please give your response in the chat box. Remaining topic will be discussed in the next class. All the students must give